Well, you know, obviously, just so proud of our football team to find our way back to our second conference championship game in the last 2 years. The things that we've seen throughout this year, some of the adversity that's shown up at 1.1-3 in conference play, and went into a bye week, continued to build off what the culture and the values of our program are, and our guys did an incredible job of responding to win our last four, to make it here to the championship game. It's an incredible feat, and we know that we're going to be playing an outstanding opponent here in Central Florida, a team that has been dominant throughout the season, throughout the last 2 years, and to be able to come back to Orlando for one game and one opportunity to be the American Conference champions, our kids are extremely excited, and we're honored to be in this position. You know, I think each experience is unique to itself, and what our team has been through, the way they've matured throughout this season, it has been a special journey. And I know last week when we were able to defeat Houston, it was a wide range of emotions, and knowing that we'd be coming back to Orlando, an opportunity to compete against one of the best teams in the country, a top 10 opponent, here in with the opportunity to achieve one of the goals that we set out for at the beginning of the year, I mean, you can't ask for much more. And I believe every experience that we've had has helped prepare us for this opportunity. You walk in, you see that trophy, and that's what we aspire to achieve tomorrow. And we know it's going to be a great challenge. We're looking forward to the matchup, and our team has done a wonderful job in preparing for the chance to kick it off there tomorrow. I absolutely hate it for that young man. When I saw the injury, I was truly heartbroken because, getting a chance, when you play in this conference, we played UCF three times in the last 2 years. And so I've got a chance to compete against one of the greatest competitors in college football. And, every time I've had the opportunity to be around him, whether it was media day or whatever the event was, just such a genuine young man. And So you hate to see anybody go down, but somebody of his status, of what he's done, and how he impacts so many, now coming into this game, obviously we're preparing to go out there and compete against the Central Florida football team, and this is a special team that we're playing, and obviously there's a lot of great individuals, but how they've responded to any adversity they've seen, the way that they've continued to grow as a program, through a coaching change from last year to this year, and some of the things that they face this year, it's impressive to watch. So injuries are a part of the game, unfortunately. So you've got to prepare for whoever steps on that field, and go out there and put your best foot forward. And I know our team's excited about the opportunity to do that. Yeah, anytime you play in a championship caliber game, which we've been fortunate the last couple of weeks, we've had high emotions because we had to win to have the opportunity to get to this point. And so, we've got to just truly focus on ourselves. Don't get distracted by anything on the outside, whether it's the crowd, whether the weather, anything that might show up. We've got to stay focused on doing our job. And our team has really, I think they've grown so much through every experience. Last week against Houston, we started off, we were probably a little emotionally geared up to start that game, didn't play our best ball there those first couple series, but then when we calmed down and got into the flow of the game, I thought we responded at a high level. So it's going to be a lot the same tomorrow. We know there's going to be momentum swings, just like any time you go on the road. You've got to be able to control what you can control and just stay focused on doing the job and the task that's at hand. And so I think our team will be ready for that, and heck, we faced adversity all through the season, so we just got to build off those experiences that we faced.
It's one thing to be here, it's another thing to be back. What does it say about the program that you're back in consecutive years, and then secondly, to do something which is to win the thing that the program's never done over there?
Oh, it'd mean everything. And, you know, opportunity to represent the West Division in back-to-back years is something we take a great deal of pride in, because it is a challenge. You know, there's a lot of great football teams in this league. You know, each week you've got to bring your A game. And, you know, for our team to be able to battle through to find our way in the championship game for in consecutive years, it is a heck of an accomplishment. And, you know, coming into this game, no matter what the journey looked like, you know, it comes down to one game, it comes down to 60 minutes. And, you know, the winner of tomorrow's contest is going to hoist that trophy, and that is something that you know, our kids are passionate about. We know that would be a symbolic moment for our football program in continuing to the progression of where we want to go here in the long term for our future. But I'm really proud that we have the opportunity and been able to get to this point. You know, it's really not, to be honest with you. I mean, you know, our focus is on this game. You know, we look back at the experience of playing them, you know, this, you know, during the season, and we have to be better than what we were, you know, there at the midpoint when we faced them in Memphis. And so, you know, at the end of the day, we shouldn't need to motivate our guys with anything on the outside. We're playing for the American Conference Championship. We're playing the top 10 team in the country, and you know, it's going to be a heck of a game. It's going to be a heck of a matchup. You know, obviously, you know, we have been here before. We are familiar with the personnel that we're going to go up against, but we also familiar with the challenge that it's going to be. So at the end of the day, I've been very pleased with how our kids have approached this week. You know, they came out, they practiced, you know, at an elite level throughout it. And because we know that the only chance we have to be successful is that we had to maximize on every opportunity building to this game. And, you know, I believe that we've been able to accomplish that. And, you know, we're excited to kick it off tomorrow. You know, I've seen this team mature, and you know, coming into the season, you know, there were expectations. You know, we all had high expectations of getting to this point and being able to play in this game. But you know, we knew there was also going to be challenges. When you only have 8 seniors, it's the smallest senior class I've ever been around. You had to see guys really emerge as a leader within the leadership of our football team, and seeing guys like DeMonte Coxey, you know, our running backs Darrell Henderson, Patrick Taylor, Tony Pollard, you know, guys J.J. Russell, Bryce Huff, that you know, even though they're not seniors, they've had to really establish themselves as go-to guys and somebody that can be counted on when things maybe aren't going well for us. And that's what I've enjoyed more than anything else, is seeing a team that has learned from some of the disappointments, some of the setbacks, and they've been able to apply the correction and put it into action there on game day to be able to get back to this point. I tell people all the time, you know, football is the greatest example of what life is going to be. You know, like everybody pictures a fairy tale of what it is to get to be successful, but you know, it doesn't work out that way all the time, and you have to be able to respond. And you control how you respond to every situation. You control how you prepare, and you control the belief and you have with the culture that we've been able to establish. And so, seeing all that play through, I think that helps us for tomorrow's contest, because you'll see all those emotions show up again through this 60-minute contest that we're going to have. You know, he's a talented young man. You know, obviously, he's got great size, you know, over 230 pounds. He's got great speed. And you watch the East Carolina game, which he started, you know, on the road. You know, definitely a dynamic player with the ball in his hands. So he's got a strong arm, can push the ball down the field. I guess when you look at the grand scheme of it, he is a redshirt freshman. He doesn't have the experience and the number of snaps of you know, a guy that's usually playing in this game. But, you know, he's been very productive. And you look at their team, the two contests which he's played extensive snaps in have both been on the road against, you know, quality opponents in adverse situations. And he's done a great job, and the team has rallied around him, you know, both dominant victories. I think it was 37-10 against East Carolina and 38-10 last week against South Florida. And so this team, you know, definitely has a great belief in him. You have to adjust some things, but he can operate their system. You know, is he going to be Mackenzie Milton taking the snap and being able to do all the different things? You know, I don't know. We don't have a big enough a sample size to tell, but I can tell you he's very talented and he can do a lot of great things for him, and he's surrounded by a wonderful supporting cast. Well, I mean, we're excited that we're in this game. And, you know, when you're two of the top programs in a league, then you get a chance to play against each other and multiple times. There's a healthy respect. And, you know, our games have been incredible. You know, you talked about the championship game last year, obviously the one-point game here this year. We know that this is going to be a game that's going to come down to one play. And so to say rivalry, I don't know about that. I mean, you know, I think that it's a game of two great football teams that have done what's necessary to get to this point. And, you know, I know for the American Conference, it's an exciting game. And it's definitely a tribute to what's going on in our league, you know, as we've been able to push and gain that national relevance because of the way that these teams have played.
If they win, they presumably will go on to an access ball. If you win, you will not. I think that doesn't diminish winning a championship for you, but do you get the sense that you're that the conference would prefer that UCF? I mean, as you walk around here, you're thinking, boy, you could ruin things for the conference.
Well, I can tell you that you know, I know we're excited about the opportunity, and you know, I'll tell you the one thing about the American Conference is that, you know, every opportunity we step on the field, no matter what team shows up, there's going to be a high standard and a high level of competition and performance. We've got great coaches, we've got great players. You know, you're going to turn on your ABC here tomorrow, and no matter where you are in the country, and you're going to see a great brand of football. And so this is a championship game, and you know, either team can win. Either team, this is probably the two most competitive teams that our league has to show at the present moment, and you know, we're definitely excited for the opportunity. Whatever feelings go beyond that, I don't know. I know our team's ready to go out there and compete for a championship. You know, the things people forget, you know, everybody talks about the streak and how many wins they've been able to stop. Well, they're in year one with their coaching staff. And to see the growth, the confidence that they have playing within the scheme, I believe Coach Heupel and his staff have done a great job. And you can see their team growing in what they're being asked to do. And there is some carryover from last year to this year. But, you know, their guys are playing faster. There's a great trust that's been established throughout their journey. And so they are playing at an elite level. And you watch what they've done on the field the last few weeks. It's impressive. And you know, our guys, you know, we have a very healthy respect for what we're gonna, for who we're gonna go against, and what we're gonna see tomorrow. So it's definitely gonna take our best effort. You know, he's excited about the opportunity, and you know, I've said, you know, throughout the year, Brady prepares as well as probably any player I've ever been around. You know, he understands the role that he has, and he's got to lead an offense that, you know, does have a lot of weapons. And you know, we're going to be multiple in what we do. We've got some dynamic players, you know, on the perimeter, and he's got to do a great job of controlling the game. We need to be efficient in the passing game. Hopefully we'll be able to hit some explosive plays on the perimeter. But, you know, one of the things that we need to improve on is, you know, we've got to own the football. And the last couple of weeks we've turned the ball over for a variety of reasons. But we know that's going to be a big factor in this game. UCF's plus 16 on the year in turnover margin. You know, obviously we're only plus 2. That's pretty indicative of why they haven't lost any games and why we've had a couple setbacks. So, you know, for us, it's about, you know, going out there and playing clean football. I know Brady is excited. Our team has full confidence in what he's going to do in leading our offense and this football team. And, you know, we're looking forward to it. Yes, sir. I mean, that's something we had a kind of commemorative ball for this game, and you know, it's just for McKenzie, just to tell him that you know, he's in our thoughts and prayers, and we wish him to, you know, all the best in a speedy recovery. You know, I mentioned him as one of the greatest competitors in college football. And, you know, I've been around this game for a good while, and I've been able to compete against a lot of great athletes. And, you know, he is so impactful in all that he does, not just on the field, You watch the way that people respond to him, and this is because of my experience at Media Days and being around him. I've got a lot of respect for that young man, and when I say it was heartbreaking to see him go down, you hate seeing good, adversity show up for really good people. But I know he's going to respond, and as a football team, we wanted to have a gesture just to say that we're there in full support of a speedy recovery for him, because I know he's going to continue to impact this game and going to have a great recovery here in front of him, and we just wanted him to know that our thoughts and prayers were with him. All right, guys, thanks so much.